In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
So we gather on the Lord's Day, we pause and take a moment as we begin the celebration of the Eucharist to look into our hearts, to ask God to help us to call to mind our sins and our shortcomings, to ask his forgiveness and his grace, to grow into the kind of holy people he always wanted us to be. And so, brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense, he comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then will the tongue of the mute sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord, my soul. Praise God of Jacob keeps faith forever, secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free. Praise the Lord, my soul. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who were bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects strangers. Praise the Lord, my soul. The fatherless and the widow the Lord sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever. Your God, O Zion, through all generations. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, my soul.
A reading from the letter of St. James. My brothers and sisters, show no partiality as you adhere to the faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ. For if a man with gold rings and fine clothes comes into your assembly, and a poor person in shabby clothes also comes in, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say, "Sit here, please," while you say to the poor one, "Stand there," or "Sit at my feet," have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil designs? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters, did not God choose those who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom that he promised to those who love him? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee into the district of Decapolis. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay hands on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and, spitting, touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, "Ephphatha," that is, "be opened." And immediately the man's ears were opened, his speech impediment was removed, and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone, But the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord.
Sir, I'm sure you're wondering, what's with the vestment? I only wear this on special occasions. Last night I wore it. We have our big festival down at Good Samaritan, and at 11:30, quarter to 12, midnight, 12:15, whenever they're done cleaning the grounds, they all gather for mass. And generally what I say to them is, I just want you to know from the bottom of my heart that you've been here for, some of you, 12 hours cooking and slaving and everything. I want to tell you two things: that I really appreciate all the hard work you've done, and that you really, really need a shower. But I got this vestment as an ordination present from Yinka Aganga Williams and her friends at St. Benedict the Moor in the Hill District. She's from the Yoruba tribe of Nigeria, and she made it herself. And I wear it on special occasions like today. The readings today are kind of strange. Imagine Jesus walking up to this guy who's deaf and mute. He wants to be cured, but he doesn't really understand probably what's going on because he's deaf and he can't speak. Jesus puts his fingers in his ears and spits and touches his tongue and says, "Ephatha, be opened." And all of a sudden he can hear again and he can speak. And kind of the miraculous thing is that he can speak clearly, because if you can't hear words, you don't know how to form your tongue and your mouth to make the words. You couldn't expect him to understand what he was saying, because it would have taken him probably years of listening to other people to learn how to speak that way himself. But he was able to speak clearly, and it was just a miracle. But the great miracle wasn't that just that he could hear and speak, but it opened a whole new world to him. Imagine what it must be like not being able to hear what everyone else is saying to you. And I think maybe worse than that is not being able to tell people anything. That you love them, that you're upset, that you're in pain. I had a dear friend who was deaf, and it was amazing to me that he could speak as well as he did. He worked really hard at it. And it's a world that we can't begin to understand. But God bless them, they're just amazing. But in this guy's life, it must have been even worse, because in that Old Testament mentality, they thought that anyone who had something bad happen to them, that they must have sinned. They felt that what goes around comes around in this lifetime. If you were a really good person, you'd have all of the wealth that you wanted. You'd have a beautiful wife. If you were bad, you'd marry some guy who tells really, really bad jokes and thinks he's funny. But his whole world changed and it opened up. You have to read these things, not just at the surface level of that God was able to work miracles. And Jesus did those miracles to prove that he was, in fact, the Son of God. He was God himself. So that people would pay attention, and not everyone did. Some of them dismissed the miracles as parlor tricks because they were jealous. They were listening but not hearing. The second way you have to read the scripture is, okay, what's the symbolic meaning? And the symbolic meaning is for us, is do we listen and not hear? Do we really, really understand what's going on around us in the world? Do we pay attention? especially to those who love us. Sometimes we're so self-absorbed in whatever crisis we're dealing with that we forget about the people around us and that we don't hear what they're asking. It happened to me last night. I was at the festival and I was running late. I was getting ready for confessions. And I had done a trip to the hospital to anoint somebody who was dying. And we were setting up for one of the booths. And this teenage girl came up to me and she tapped me on the shoulder and said, hi. And I said, I don't have time to talk. I really am late for confessions. I got to run. And then afterwards, I felt really bad because I wasn't paying attention to her. And I could just as easily, in that same 15 seconds, said, hi, it's good seeing you. I'm sorry I can't talk right now. I'm really, really busy, but I'll call you later. I sent her a text message saying, I'm sorry if I was rude to you. And she texted me back, that's okay. I could tell you were really, really busy. I was just going to ask if you were okay and needed any help. Sometimes we just don't listen. I remember going through papers when my mom died after I got out of seminary and seeing this note from her talking about little dumb things, you know. And at the end of it, she said, if you get a chance, at least once a week, could you just send me an email or call me or just say hi so I know you're okay. And I realized that in my busyness and trying to pass all the classes and learn about how to be pastoral to people, I was neglecting my mom. All she wanted was to hear my voice once in a while. I mean, she carried me for 9 months and changed diapers for so many years. It's the least I could do, but I didn't hear till she was already gone. And how often do we do that? It's so important that we listen to the people around us, that we hear what they're saying and hear in between the lines sometimes. And it takes a little work to listen that way. I did two funerals this past week, one for a 97-year-old who was my altar boy until he was 86. And I did a funeral for a little girl who was just 2 months shy of her second birthday. Just the sweetest kid. She lived in Franklin, PA, near Oil City. And she just smiled all the time. And she was completely fearless. And she would walk up to everyone and, hi, hi, hi. She was fearless. Everyone that she met wasn't a stranger. It was just a new friend she hadn't met yet. And her dad was just one of those doting dads. And she only had about a 6-word vocabulary, one of which was dada. And her father told me at the funeral that whenever they would go somewhere and she would meet a new person and they would say, this is your great aunt on your mom's side. And she would turn and point to her father and say, dada, like she was introducing him because she was so proud of him. How beautiful is it that he was able to speak a little kid, that he understood how much she cared and admired him. How often do we miss those chances, whether it's talking to your teenage children or talking to the next door neighbor or talking to your spouse? How often do we miss the chance to listen with our hearts, not just to them, but to God? And if we can find the ability to hear better, to listen with our hearts to God and to those around us, want to change our world and make it just a little brighter place to live. Together, let us rise and profess what we believe. For I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And together, let us lift up our prayers and offer them before the Lord's table.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer, for Pope Francis and Bishop Zubik, that they might help the church hear the voice of God through their ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the participants and leaders of the Women's Welcome Retreat next weekend, that they might be overwhelmed by the love of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our recently fallen servicemen and women, and for all who protect and defend our country, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering the effects of the Hurricane Ida and its aftermath, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our family and friends who have died and gone before us, may they come to share the eternal life of the risen Christ. And for Richard Eichner, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we lift up all of our dear brothers and sisters that suffer from hearing loss, that the Lord would touch them and heal them and help them to navigate all of the difficult things that we just take for granted. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We take a moment in silence to lift up all the prayers we brought with us to Mass this day. Heavenly Father, we gather as a family of faith and offer these prayers with one voice, united in our love for you. We ask them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us rise and pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." I'm sorry, I skipped something. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere. To give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son. By whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
My sisters and brothers, behold Jesus Christ. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
I invite all the children who are present to rise, and any of the children who are watching on the internet to draw near to the computer screen as Deacon Tom and I impart a blessing. Heavenly Father, pour forth your grace and your blessing on these little ones, the future of our church. Help them to grow in love with you and to listen to one another, not just with their ears, but with their hearts. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let the church say amen. Amen. And let us rise and pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Just a few announcements. Our parish festival down at Good Samaritan for Good Samaritan St. John's and Our Lady of Peace is continuing today. The festival hours are until, I think, 9:30 this evening, and they're having hot meals and pierogi and all kinds of other things. You're all welcome to join. This weekend, the golf committee has raffle baskets in the Narthex. The raffle and the golf tournament benefit our nonprofit neighbor fund. Parish offices will be closed on Monday, September 6th, and on Friday, September 10th. And mass schedule changes take place effective next weekend. Please see the Evangelium for the complete list of masses. And note that a decision was made after the publication of the bulletin to keep the Sunday 7 p.m. mass for the time being because of the COVID spread. And this is your last chance to register for the search session, which begins Wednesday, September 15th. If you know anyone who wants to dig deeper into their faith or somebody who's questioning, it's a great opportunity. Please join me in praying the St. Michael the Archangel prayer. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. I apologize for the mistake in the middle of Mass. When I heard the kneelers crashing to the ground, I realized I missed part of the Mass. To be honest with you, had to go back and do it again. To be honest with you, I was absorbed in myself thinking that and my homily, I probably inadvertently said something. Either hurtful or insulting about having a disability of speech impediment or hearing. If I insulted anyone, please, from the bottom of my heart, I hope you'll forgive me. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Heavenly Father, pour forth your grace and your spirit upon this, your people. Touch their hearts and their minds and draw them ever closer to you. May the blessing of Almighty God descend upon you and remain with you always. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let the church say amen.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. May the rest of your week be blessed.
Have a great holiday. Have a nice week. Great week.